Put your hands where the progress is. Serving you is the objective. We going all the way. Progress is all the way. Came on stronger now. Came on stronger now. We coming stronger now. We coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Stronger say my game on.
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 Stronger say my
game on. Progressive. Put your hands for the progressive. Serving you. Stronger now, we coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Yeah. Put your hands where the progress is. Serving you is the objective. We going all the way. Progress is all the way. Came on stronger now. Came on stronger now. Coming stronger now, we coming stronger now. This country stronger now, this country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now, let's keep it stronger. Stronger say my game on.
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 Stronger say my
game on. Progressive all the way. Put your hands for the progressive. Serving you.
Georgetown Central is my hometown. It's where I born, raised, and still continue to live. Whatever happens in Georgetown, I'm a part of it. It affects me. After seeing the past representation, I knew that the people of Georgetown needed better and deserved better.
It's time for Georgetown Central to have solid representation, not in the opposition, but within government. You deserve someone that knows their way around the system and is able to take on your issues and concerns and resolve them. Now is not the time for still can. Now is the time for will do. I am calling on Georgetown Central to vote for me. Number two, Frank Cornwall, because I'm the right man for the job.
Put your hands for the progressives. Serving you is the
option. You may love Cayman as much as I do, but you will never love Cayman more than I do.
I've spent over 60 years in Georgetown West. I grew up on South Church Street, Georgetown West. I've spent the majority of my working life, Walker's Road, that's Georgetown West. I have been very active in the community for many years and showed that I care about our people and what is best for these islands. Sports is in my blood. Helping people is in my blood. So when I can help people through sports, I am happy to know that I am using my passion to make the Cayman Islands a better place.
On April the 14th, vote number 4, David Wight, Georgetown West, and vote for the progressive, stronger, safer future.
Put your hands for the progressive, serving you.
The characteristics of Barbara Conolly: kind, compassionate, loving, a community activist, hard worker, passionate about my elderly and the youth. Barbara Conolly is one of them that gets the job done, but she does not just delegate. She gets out there with her people and she's underground or in the field working with my people. It's a 24/7 job and I'm at everyone in Georgetown South. If they call me, whatever time of day, night, morning, noon, whatever, I have to be there for them because I chose then to be their servant. On April the 14th, I appeal to you to vote number one on my ballot paper. I promise you, I will do my utmost to represent you to the best of my ability.
Put your hands where the progress is. Serving you is the objective.
My father always told me, he said, I should either have been a lawyer or a politician because I was always very argumentative and I was always speaking up and speaking out.
Cayman needs strong, stable government. Our alliance is the only grouping running in this election with any significant track record of achievement in government.
I am quite capable of being strong, dogmatic, and forceful when time and circumstances demand it. And I did not get where I am by being weak and soft. I think that I bring the right skills. I think I bring the right qualities, the right experience into this role. I think the future really looks bright for Cayman once we get past the pandemic and we can put this behind us, get all of our people vaccinated, and get your country completely open.
Put your hands where the progress is. Serving you is the objective.
Hi, this is journalist Kayla Young with the Cayman Compass. We're standing on the beach between Prospect and Spots where the Costa Luminosa cruise ship is anchored just offshore. The ship encountered problems earlier in Ocho Rios, Jamaica over its Italian passengers and fear of coronavirus.
As I'm sure everyone is painfully aware, the entire world is grappling with COVID-19, the virus that is killing thousands of people and crippling economies around the world.
Be with you today to bring some good news regarding government's national vaccination program. As a country, we have done extremely well with the vaccine rollout, and we can all be very proud of this. There have been nearly 320 million COVID-19 vaccinations given around the world. I can further report that some 31% of our population of around 65,000 people have received at least one dose, and 15% have had a full course. I'm extremely pleased to also announce that we have reached a much anticipated milestone in the delivery of our program, in that we have now vaccinated well over 91% of those in our population over the age of 60. I am able to announce today that from the 22nd of March, the required quarantine period will be reduced from 14 to 10 days for those who have completed a valid vaccination program at least 2 weeks before traveling to the Cayman Islands, provided that everyone in their quarantine group has also been vaccinated. Other requirements are that a traveler must provide a negative PCR test that was taken no more than 72 hours prior to departure. A negative PCR test is also completed when arriving on island, and the traveler is staying in a group where all people have received a full course of the vaccination. And that to be released from quarantine, the traveler must receive a negative PCR test.
Hello, prospect. Serving you and these beautiful islands is my heart. I have committed myself in service to you so that together we can make a change for the better. We have made a good start here in Prospect, but we need to solve the traffic congestion problem and introduce more speed bumps. We also need to develop a comprehensive floodwater management system while creating greater public open spaces where our children may play. The good news is I have a plan, and together we can achieve it. So, on April 14th, vote number one, Austin Harris, for a stronger, safer Prospect.
Stronger now, came on stronger now, we coming stronger now, we coming stronger now, this country stronger now, this country stronger now, stronger now, let's keep it stronger, yeah. Put your hands for the progressive, serving you. Coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Stronger say back game on.
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 Stronger say back
game on. Progressive all the way. Put your hands for the progressive. Serving you. Stronger now, came on stronger now, we coming stronger now, we coming stronger now, this country stronger now, this country stronger now, let's keep it stronger now, let's keep it stronger, yeah. Put your hands for the progressive, serving you. Stronger now, we coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Stronger say back game on.
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 Stronger say back
game on. Progressive all the way. Put your hands for the progressive. Serving you. Came on stronger now, came on stronger now, we coming stronger now, we coming stronger now, this country stronger now, this country stronger now, let's keep it stronger now, let's keep it stronger,
yeah.
Put your hands for the progressive, serving you.
stronger now. We coming stronger now. We coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger.
Stronger say back in man.
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 Georgetown Central is my hometown. It's where I born, raised, and still continue to live. Whatever happens in Georgetown, I'm a part of it. It affects me. After seeing the past representation, I knew that the people of Georgetown needed better and deserved better.
It's time for Georgetown Central to have solid representation, not in the opposition, but within government. You deserve someone that knows their way around the system and is able to take on your issues and concerns and resolve them. Now is not the time for still can. Now is the time for will do. I am calling on Georgetown Central to vote for me. Number two, Frank Cornwall, because I'm the right man for the job.
Put your heads for the progress.
You may love Cayman as much as I do, but you will never love Cayman more than I do.
I've spent over 60 years in Georgetown West. I grew up on South Church Street, Georgetown West. I've spent the majority of my working life, Walker's Road, that's Georgetown West. I have been very active in the community for many years and showed that I care about our people and what is best for these islands. Sports is in my blood. Helping people is in my blood. So when I can help people through sports, I am happy to know that I'm using my passion to make the Cayman Islands a better place.
On April the 14th, vote number 4, David Wight, Georgetown West, and vote for the progressives. stronger, safer future.
Put your hands where the progress is. Serving you is the objective.
Characteristics of Barbara Conolly: kind, compassionate, loving, a community activist, hard worker, passionate about my elderly and the youth. Barbara Conolly is one of them that gets the job done, but she does not just delegate. She gets out there with her people and she's underground or in the field working with my people. It's a 24/7 job and I'm at everyone in Georgetown South. If they call me, whatever time of day, night, morning, noon, whatever, I have to be there for them because I chose then to be their servant. On April the 14th, I appeal to you to vote number one on my ballot paper. I promise you, I will do my utmost to represent you to the best of my ability.
Put your hands where the progress is. Serving you is the objective.
My father always told me, he said, I should either have been a lawyer or a politician because I was always very argumentative and I was always speaking up and speaking out.
Cayman needs strong, stable government. Our alliance is the only grouping running in this election with any significant track record of achievement in government.
I am quite capable of being strong, dogmatic, and forceful when time and circumstances demand it. And I did not get where I am by being weak and soft. I think that I bring the right skills. I think I bring the right qualities, the right experience into this role. I think the future really looks bright for Cayman once we get past the pandemic and we can put this behind us, get all of our people vaccinated and get your country completely open.
Put your hands where the progress is. Serving you is the objective.
Hi, this is journalist Kayla Young with the Cayman Compass. We're standing on the beach between Prospect and Spots, where the Costa Luminosa cruise ship is anchored just offshore. The ship encountered problems earlier in Ocho Rios, Jamaica, over its Italian passengers and fear of coronavirus.
As I'm sure everyone is painfully aware, the entire world is grappling with COVID-19, the virus that is killing thousands of people and crippling economies around the world. To be with you today to bring some good news regarding government's national vaccination program. As a country, we have done extremely well with the vaccine rollout, and we can all be very proud of this. There have been nearly 320 million COVID-19 vaccinations given around the world. I can further report that some 31% of our population of around 65,000 people have received at least one dose, and 15% have had a full course. I'm extremely pleased to also announce that we have reached a much anticipated milestone in the delivery of our program, in that we have now vaccinated well over 91% of those in our population over the age of 60. I am able to announce today that from the 22nd of March, the required quarantine period will be reduced from 14 to 10 days for those who have completed a valid vaccination program at least 2 weeks before traveling to the Cayman Islands, provided that everyone in their quarantine group has also been vaccinated. Other requirements are that a traveler must provide a negative PCR test that was taken no more than 72 hours prior to departure. A negative PCR test is also completed when arriving on island, and the traveler is staying in a group where all people have received a full course of the vaccination. And that to be released from quarantine, the traveler must receive a negative PCR test.
Hello, Prospect. Serving you and these beautiful islands is my heart. I have committed myself in service to you so that together we can make a change for the better. We have made a good start here in Prospect, but we need to solve the traffic congestion problem and introduce more speed bumps. We also need to develop a comprehensive floodwater management system while creating greater public open spaces where our children may play. The good news is I have a plan, and together we can achieve it. So on April 14th, vote number one, Austin Harris, for a stronger, safer Prospect.
Stronger now, came on stronger now, we coming stronger now. We coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Put your X for the progress. Serving you is the objective. We going all the way. Progress is all the way. Came on stronger now. Came on stronger now. We coming stronger now. Coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now.
Let's keep it stronger.
Stronger say Bucky man.
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 Stronger say Bucky
man. Progressive all the way. Put your hands for the progressive. Serving you.
Georgetown Central is my hometown. It's where I born, raised, and still continue to live. Whatever happens in Georgetown, I'm a part of it. It affects me. After seeing the past representation, I knew that the people of Georgetown needed better and deserve better.
It's time for Georgetown Central to have solid representation, not in the opposition, but within government. You deserve someone that knows their way around the system and is able to take on your issues and concerns and resolve them. Now is not the time for scan. Now is the time for will do. I am calling on Georgetown Central to vote for me. Number two, Frank Cornwall, because I'm the right man for the job.
Put your hands for the progressive. Serving you is the objective.
You may love Cayman as much as I do, but you will never love Cayman more than I do.
I've spent over 60 years in Georgetown West. I grew up on South Church Street, Georgetown West. I've spent the majority of my working life, Walker's Road, that's Georgetown West. I have been very active in the community for many years and showed that I care about our people and what is best for these islands. Sports is in my blood. Helping people is in my blood. So when I can help people through sports, I am happy to know that I'm using my passion to make the Cayman Islands a better place.
On April the 14th, vote number 4, David Wight, Georgetown West, and vote for the progressive, stronger, safer future.
Put your hands for the progressive. Serving you is the objective.
The characteristics of Barbara Conolly: kind, compassionate, loving, a community activist, hard worker, passionate about my elderly and the youth. Barbara Conolly is one of them that gets the job done, but she does not just delegate. She gets out there with her people and she's underground or in the field working with my people. It's a 24/7 job and I'm at everyone in Georgetown South. If they call me, whatever time of day, night, morning, noon, whatever, I have to be there for them because I chose then to be their servant. On April the 14th, I appeal to you to vote number one on my ballot paper. I promise you, I will do my utmost to represent you to the best of my ability.
Put your hands where the progress is, serving you is the objective.
My father always told me, he said, I should either have been a lawyer or a politician because I was always very argumentative and I was always speaking up and speaking out.
Cayman needs strong, stable government. Our alliance is the only grouping running in this election with any significant track record of achievement in government.
I am quite capable of being strong, dogmatic, and forceful when time and circumstances demand it. And I did not get where I am by being weak and soft. I think that I bring the right skills. I think I bring the right qualities, the right experience into this role. I think the future really looks bright for Cayman once we get past the pandemic and we can put this behind us, get all of our people vaccinated and get your country completely open.
Put your hands where the progress
is. Hi, this is journalist Kayla Young with the Cayman Compass. We're standing on the beach between Prospect and Spots where the Costa Luminosa cruise ship is anchored just offshore. The ship encountered problems earlier in Ocho Rios, Jamaica over its Italian passengers and fear of coronavirus.
As I'm sure everyone is painfully aware, the entire world is grappling with COVID-19, the virus that is killing thousands of people and crippling economies around the world.
To be with you today to bring some good news regarding government's national vaccination program. As a country, we have done extremely well with the vaccine rollout, and we can all be very proud of this. There have been nearly 320 million COVID-19 vaccinations given around the world. I can further report that some 31% of our population of around 65,000 people have received at least one dose, and 15% have had a full course. I'm extremely pleased to also announce that we have reached a much anticipated milestone in the delivery of our program, in that we have now vaccinated well over 91% of those in our population over the age of 60. I am able to announce today that from the 22nd of March, the required quarantine period will be reduced from 14 to 10 days for those who have completed a valid vaccination program at least 2 weeks before traveling to the Cayman Islands, provided that everyone in their quarantine group has also been vaccinated. Other requirements are that a traveler must provide a negative PCR test that was taken no more than 72 hours prior to departure. A negative PCR test is also completed when arriving on island, and the traveler is staying in a group where all people have received a full course of the vaccination. And that to be released from quarantine, the traveler must receive a negative PCR test.
Hello, prospect. Serving you and these beautiful islands is my heart. I have committed myself in service to you so that together we can make a change for the better. We have made a good start here in Prospect, but we need to solve the traffic congestion problem and introduce more speed bumps. We also need to develop a comprehensive floodwater management system while creating greater public open spaces where our children may play. The good news is I have a plan, and together we can achieve it. So, on April 14th, vote number one, Austin Harris, for a stronger, safer Prospect.
Stronger now, came on stronger now, we coming stronger now, we coming stronger now, this country stronger now, this country stronger now, let's keep it stronger now, let's keep it stronger, put your ex for the progress, serving you. Stronger now, we coming stronger now. This country stronger now, this country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now, let's keep it stronger.
Stronger Sipa Key Man,
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 stronger Sipa
Key Man.
Stronger now, we coming stronger now. This country stronger now, this country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now, let's keep it stronger. Put your ex for the progress, serving you is the objective. We going all the way, progressive all the way. Came on stronger now, came on stronger now. Coming stronger now, we coming stronger now. This country stronger now, this country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now, let's keep it stronger.
Stronger Sipa Key Man,
stronger Sipa Key Man,
stronger Sipa Key Man,
stronger Sipa Key Man,
stronger Sipa Key Man.
Georgetown Central is my hometown. It's where I born, raised, and still continue to live. Whatever happens in Georgetown, I'm a part of it. It affects me. After seeing the past representation, I knew that the people of Georgetown needed better and deserve better.
It's time for Georgetown Central to have solid representation, not in the opposition, but within government. You deserve someone that knows their way around the system and is able to take on your issues and concerns and resolve them. Now is not the time for still can. Now is the time for will do. I am calling on Georgetown Central to vote for me, number 2, Frank Cornwall, because I'm the right man for the job.
Put your hands for the progressives. Serving you is the objective.
You may love Cayman as much as I do, but you will never love Cayman more than I do.
I've spent over 60 years in Georgetown West. I grew up on South Church Street, Georgetown West. I've spent the majority of my working life, Walker's Road, that's Georgetown West. I have been very active in the community for many years and showed that I care about our people and what is best for these islands. Sports is in my blood. Helping people is in my blood. So when I can help people through sports, I am happy to know that I'm using my passion to make the Cayman Islands a better place.
On April the 14th, vote number 4, David Wight, Georgetown West, and vote for the progressives, stronger, safer future.
Put your hands for the progressives, serving you.
The characteristics of Barbara Conolly: kind, compassionate, loving, a community activist, hard worker, passionate about my elderly and the youth. Barbara Conolly is one of them that gets the job done, but she does not just delegate. She gets out there with her people and she's underground or in the field working with my people. It's a 24/7 job and I'm at everyone in Georgetown South. If they call me, whatever time of day, night, morning, noon, whatever, I have to be there for them because I chose then to be their servant. On April the 14th, I appeal to you to vote number 1 on my ballot paper. I promise you, I will do my utmost to represent you to the best of my ability.
Put your hands for the progressives.
My father always told me, he said, I should either have been a lawyer or a politician, because I was always very argumentative and I was always speaking up and speaking out.
Cayman needs strong, stable government. Our alliance is the only grouping running in this election with any significant track record of achievement in government.
I am quite capable of being strong, dogmatic, and forceful when time and circumstances demand it. And I did not get where I am by being weak and soft. I think that I bring the right skills. I think I bring the right qualities, the right experience into this role. I think the future really looks bright for Cayman once we get past the pandemic and we can put this behind us, get all of our people vaccinated, and get your country completely open.
Put your hands for the progressive. Serving you is the objective.
Here's one way to vote.
Vote progressive. Vote progressive.
For a stronger, safer future.
Progressives are sure.
Progressive. Vote progressive. Vote progressive. Vote progressive. Stronger, safer future. Vote progressive. Stronger, safer future. Vote progressive.
Caring and trusted in the Cayman Islands. That's progressive for sure. Stronger and safer. Our future leaders. Make sure progressive you vote.
For a stronger, safer future.
There's one way to vote.
Vote progressive.
David and Frank, stronger.
Vote progressive.
Moses and Julie, safer.
Vote progressive.
Barbara and Alden, stronger.
Vote progressive.
Joey and Ryan, safer.
Vote progressive.
Stronger, safer future.
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 Good evening, good evening, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And welcome to this, the final rally of your alliance team here in beautiful Georgetown. First, I want to begin by welcoming all of you who have come out tonight to join our final rally. Whilst I still see a number of you still on the wings and the corner, there's lots of room in the midfield. So come sit down. Take the load off and enjoy yourself. We're going to have a great time tonight. I also want to say good evening and welcome to all of those persons joining us through the use of technology. First of all, those joining us via live broadcast on Rooster 101, as well as those joining us over live streaming video on both Facebook and YouTube. Also, I want to say thanks to... lighting team, thank you all very much for, as I always say, making an ugly guy look good. But you all ready? You know who you're voting for? That's what I like to hear. Well, I'm going to give you a chance tonight to exercise those lungs. But first, before we get too long in the tooth, I want to pause and certainly seek to welcome our special guest to take up his seat. And of course, that is Almighty God. And in so doing, I want to introduce Pastor Cassius Free, or Fear, Fair to Pray. Cassius, not Clay, but Cassius Fair. For those of you who are able, please rise as we say a prayer.
Thank you very much. What a great night we are having so far. And just to say this, before I just pray this prayer for you, I know for sure that many people, even who are watching us, are so envious of us here in the Cayman Islands. And I believe that without a shadow of a doubt, if it had not been for somebody who knows how to lead and be strong, we'd not be standing here today. And having said that, today is the third day of the year 2021. And the word said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits, who healeth all thy diseases, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfied thy soul with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. Tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, is the 104th day of 2021. And incidentally, it's the same day that we will, according to the University of Google, that we will be celebrating, well, it will be 109 years since the Titanic sunk. Now, the Titanic sunk because the people who were on captain didn't have any clue as to what the direction that it should be going to. But I am very glad tonight, and that's why I'm going to be praying and standing with the group here tonight, that we need men and women with grit and guts that can be able to stand, amen, beyond, amen. So it's going to take more than a weed vote to steer the ship so that we don't have the experience that Titanic had. Are you with me? Oh, that might have gone over. Amen. But guess what happened? We have strong men and women who are leaders and who have the grit and the guts to stand to say we're going to lead our nation. With this in mind, brothers and sisters and friends, let us pray. Gracious God and Father, we come before you tonight with grateful hearts. We want to thank you, God, for the great leadership being displayed here in the Cayman Islands. And oh God, for all of what you have done for us. Truly, we are so blessed comparing to many in the world. In fact, we realize that many in the world are envious of us. But we want to thank you, God, for the great inspiration that you have placed upon our leadership. Oh God, the governance of this country. And Lord God, I pray tonight in a very special way, as our candidates will be sharing the thoughts and the different things that they will be engaged in doing for a future that is bright for this nation. May your Holy Spirit rest upon them. Thank you, God, that there are men and women of influence and prudence, that God, you will cause your spirit to rest upon them in a special way. And more so, Lord, may your spirit of the fear of the Lord and counsel and might will rest upon their lives. We bless your people. We bless our leadership here. And we pronounce heaven's benediction and favor. Yes, the ship will not go down. The ship will be on course with strong men and women who will lead this nation into victory. We thank you now. In Christ's name we pray. And everybody say, amen. Amen. God bless you, friends. Thank you so much.
Thank you to Pastor Fair. I thought I would catch you before you sat down, but I'm going to ask you to stand up again for those of you who can. Certainly, I want to welcome to sing the national song. Just to show, as she's making her way to the podium, I want to show just how close we are as a team when I say to you that everybody is hands-on, everybody is helping out. Certainly, to sing the national song, we welcome Mrs. Cynthia Hew, the wife of Minister Joey Hew.
O land of soft, fresh breezes, of verdant trees so fair, with thy Creator's glory reflected everywhere. O sea of palest emeralds, merging to darkest blue, where'er my thoughts lie God would, I'll always think of you. Dear verdant island set in blue Caribbean sea, I'm coming very soon. Oh, beauteous isles to thee. Although I've wandered far, my heart enshrines thee yet. Homeland for Cayman Isles, I cannot thee forget.
Wow, I know we got a lot of talent on this government, but I didn't realize it extended that far out to the spouses as well. Thank you, Cynthia, for that beautiful, beautiful rendition of the national song. Couldn't get all the high notes as you did, but I tried to do my best to play along. Well, again, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you to this, the final rally of the Progressives and the Alliance as we make our final push to tomorrow for Election Day. And as I said before, you know what you know who you're voting for tomorrow? Yeah. Is it the Alliance? Yeah. All right, that's what I'd like to hear. That's what I'd like to hear. Again, welcome to all who are here with us. I still see some on the wings. More room on the chairs. Please feel free to move forward and make yourself comfortable. I want to say good evening to those in the cars out there in the back who, you know, quite frankly, want to enjoy the AC and the message. Can't really blame them there. Thank you. Love to hear from you. Well, my name is Austin Harris, and I have the distinct pleasure tonight to once again play double duty. I will be both your master of ceremonies for the evening, but I'm also your candidate for the constituency of Prospect. So thank you. Thank you very much. So the good news is I get to speak twice as much, you know, so we're grateful for that little mercy as well. But we do certainly have a number of speakers tonight who will be presenting to you and their constituents to not only continue to build more support from all of you who have been with us, but also to maybe speak to some of those who are on the fence a bit. Before I begin, though, I just want to begin with a few words of thanks. First of all, as Pastor Fair certainly stated in his prayer, I want to thank Almighty God for once again allowing us another day to enjoy a COVID-free country. Yes? Not a single Caymanian lost their life in the Cayman Islands. Second, I certainly want to thank the government, which led us through the worst pandemic in the last 100 years. Many of them sit behind me here tonight, as well as recognizing those who are not with us. Please, a round of applause. Recognizing those who are not with us in the Sister Islands, of course, the Honorable Juliana Connolly and the Honorable Moses Kirkconnell, also the Minister of Health, who certainly led us through that pandemic together with the Premier and His Excellency, Dwayne John Seymour. Third, I want to thank you, the crowd, the supporters. I see so many familiar faces that I've seen following us around on this campaign trail, and I want to thank you on behalf of all of the candidates for coming out and showing your support and making us feel as if we're making an impact. So give yourselves a round of applause, and please, colleagues, a round of applause for our supporters. And last but certainly not least, all of the volunteers, the undertaking to run a campaign, particularly one with a team the size of the Alliance, takes a great deal of work. And certainly we could not have accomplished anything in setting up these meetings, planning for these meetings without the help of our many countless volunteers, certainly too many to mention, but whether they helped us with the food or whether they helped us with the chairs or the setup or the audio or the lighting or the commercials and the marketing, certainly I want to say a great big thank you on behalf of your Alliance team this evening. I would like to begin by introducing the newest member to the podium to speak to you about his plans for 2021 and beyond. He is the candidate standing for the constituency of Georgetown Central. Please put your hands together for the right man for the job, your candidate, Mr. Frank Cornwall.
What a view! What a crowd!
Cayman, are you ready? Georgetown Central, can you hear me? Are you ready? Make some noise for Northside West Bay. Kim and Brock to hear you. Well, friends, this is it. This is our last rally before you cast your vote. And dare I say, cast your votes for the Progressive Alliance. Make some noise for the progressives. Whatever happens tomorrow, I can honestly say that I've been deeply humbled by this journey. Over the last few weeks, being on the campaign trail, it's been really great chatting with so many people and hearing your thoughts about things government has done well and things you would like us to do in the next term when we are reelected. Your feedback has covered lots of different issues, but by far, the topic that you talked about most is how happy you are to go about your daily business without having to worry about wearing masks, curfews, social distancing, and community spread. For some of you, the mere thought of another lockdown gives you palpitation. At our meeting on Wednesday, I mentioned that Bermuda had logged 69 new cases, with 22 people in hospital and 5 in critical care. As of yesterday, just 4 days later, they had 41 in hospital, 6 in intensive care, and have gone back into lockdown. That just goes to show how fast things can change and take a turn for the worse. My thoughts and prayers are with them to be free from the grip of COVID very soon. The situation in Bermuda highlights that the choice you face when you step into the voting booth tomorrow could not be more clear or more serious. Your ex will not only determine this country's course for the next 4 years, but it will also decide who will steer this country through the rest of the pandemic. It will either be by the team that has kept us all safe and protected throughout the most perilous time that the world has faced in our lifetime, or it will be the other guys, none of whom have a single day's worth of experience, actually sitting in the hot seat making decisions about COVID that could affect your life. To me, the choice is a simple one. If you value the wisdom, knowledge, and good judgment that allows us all to be gathered here like this tonight, vote for it. Voters of Georgetown Central, when you step in the booth tomorrow, your choice will be a simple one too. Do you want the guy who talks a good talk? Or do you want the right man for the job? It's time you know what it feels like to have the right man in the job.
as your representative. A man who will focus on the development of our community to make it a safer and more attractive place that we can all take pride in. By improving the lighting, removing the derelict cars, increasing police patrols, and establishing more neighborhood watches, we will be sending a strong message to anyone with wrongdoing on their mind. Don't give it a second thought, because you will get caught. By developing our community and having more parks and green spaces close by, and more activities and events to bring people of all walks of life together, will unite us and strengthen the bond between us. But we must do it together. And I don't mean just the Progressives team. I mean all of you too. This is a journey that we must take together to build a safer, stronger future. So, ladies and gentlemen, I say again, if you value it, vote for it. The Progressives Manifesto clearly lays out our plans for the next 4 years and beyond. Plans that will put our economy and tourism industry back on track despite coronavirus. And allow us to continue building a nation that we can be proud of to pass on to our future generations. We can and should look to the future with optimism and with hope. Because with your support, we can and will continue to move these beloved isles forward. Tomorrow, you have the chance to re-elect a government that will build on our progress and finish what we've started. A government that is respected around the world and is smart and steady. Our opponents claim we are not good for this country. And we don't care for our people. But show me another government that has shown more care and compassion for its people than this government has. In these hard times of tourism, this government saved for a rainy day and is spending those savings on you to keep businesses open, to keep people employed, and keep food on your tables, and a roof over your head. We are the right choice, and this is the right time to have us working on your behalf. Our opponents also say that a chain is only as strong as its weakest link, inferring that I am weak, because I don't go around talking about who and who I've helped. That isn't how I operate, especially when handling people's personal and private concerns. Nope. You will never find me giving Pampers to a single mom with a camera in hand to share it with Facebook. I have too much respect for the people I serve to to do that to them. It's truly sad that the same can't be said for my opponent. But I guess when your good deeds are few and far between, and you keep falling out with your teammates, Facebook is the only friend you find. Friends, I don't work for recognition. I work with discretion because that is what service to others is all about. All day, every day, I work with constituents, back to back, and with a sympathetic heart and a genuine desire to help. Serving my people is not about me. It's about you. And when you are getting results and getting issues resolved, that is when you know you have the right man in the job. For 7 years, I have worked equally well with government and private sector, unlike my opponent, who can't work with anyone. In 4 years, he has been part of two opposition teams with two different leaders and couldn't get along with either one. That's why he sits by himself on the opposition side of parliament. But in opposition, to the opposition, unable to do anything for the good people who elect him to work on their behalf. My people, you deserve way better than that. So, Georgetown Central, when you go to the polls tomorrow, know that number two is for you. My opponent will talk and talk and talk and talk and talk about all the things that need to be done. Whereas, I will simply roll up my sleeves and get it done. While he is still talking about it, you only have two choices. One is talkative, the other is effective. It's a no-brainer to me, but it all comes down to the kind of representation you want for yourselves and your families. I hear him say he stands for Cayman first. And that's wonderful and admirable, and it sounds really good. But I say that number two is for you. Because when you are strong and working, and feel safe in your surroundings, and have a good quality of life in a community that's united, and you are prosperous and happy and feel good about the future, that is what puts Cayman first. You don't have to be a builder to know that every house must start with a strong foundation. And that's why my focus will be on putting you first, ensuring that you have what you need to make your lives better. Because when you are strong, Cayman will be strong too. If you agree with me and share that vision, all I can say is, If you value it, vote for it. You know what we stand for. You know what we will deliver. You know who our leader is. So when tomorrow comes, vote for the government that will hit the ground running from the very next day after the election. And finally, I would like to say to Georgetown Central, I have truly enjoyed being on the campaign trail with you. And I am ready to start putting our plans in action. And so I humbly asking for your support. And I hope that you will give me the chance to be your representative. All you have to do is vote number two, because number two is for you. I'll say it again for all those in the back to hear me. All those in the cars. All you have to do is vote for number two, because number two is for you. And that makes me, Frank Cornwall, the right man for the job. So look no further tomorrow. There's only one mark you got going, Georgetown Central, to look for. Number two, Frank Cornwall. The right man for the job. A man who will work with the government to make sure that you get the representation that you deserve. And not just talk about what needs to be done, but actually get it done. So I would say, Georgetown people and Cayman Islands on a whole, thank you and good night, everyone. God bless you all, and thank you for your support. Remember, the right man for the job.
This is Frank Cornwall with us. Frank Cornwall with a special message for Georgetown Central voters. I am inviting you to give yourself a strong voice in the next government by voting for me on April 14th. If you are tired of being on the outside looking in, put Frank Cornwall into Parliament to work on your behalf and put you first. As a team player, I will be a part of a government with a proven track record and a sound plan for our future. On April 14th, vote for number two, Frank Cornwall, and let's get Georgetown Central back on track.
This is a paid promotion by the Progressives.
All right, please put your hands together again. Number two is for you, Frank Cornwall, our man in Georgetown Central. Well, he was firing some shots there, Frank. Firing some shots. We talked about it before we came to the podium and said, you know what? We worked so hard for the last several weeks, it makes no sense taking any of this energy home. So he's going to leave it all on the field tonight. And he certainly did that for you tonight, didn't he? You know, he said a lot of salient points, but I think the one that caught me most peculiar was the fact that, you know, not only do you elect who will be the next government tomorrow, but you will elect the next team that will be responsible for the remaining management of this COVID-19 pandemic. Don't fool yourself in thinking that it's all over and we are in the woods, because we managed some community, you know, immunity so far, and we're getting better and closer all the time. But do you trust to put that decision in the hands of those who are untested? Think about that for a second. Or do you want to trust those that not only led us through the worst health pandemic in the last 100 years, and they're going to be the same ones to help us recover from it? Do you agree with me? Can I get an amen from the audience? Now is not the time to take unnecessary risks, Cayman. Now is not the time to change your leadership. Now is the time on Wednesday, the 14th of April, to vote in your alliance for Cayman. I would like to welcome the next speaker to the podium, a man that certainly has been my friend for the past 4 years. I've called him and oftentimes said that he is one of the nicest human beings I've ever had the pleasure of working with or even knowing. He worked with me very closely on our committee, which brought not one, but 10 solid recommendations on how to solve traffic. And as Mr. Cornwall stated, when you vote for us tomorrow, we will hit the ground running with solutions that are already in hand. Please put your hands together for my friend and yours, the candidate for Georgetown West, Mr. David White. Good evening, Cayman. Boy, Connie, you are hot tonight. Good evening to everybody here, and good evening to my people from Georgetown West. I don't plan to speak for very long tonight because it is very clear that the only choice when you go to the polls tomorrow is to vote for the progressives and members of the Alliance. I'm a former athlete, so I know a strong team when I see one, and that's why I am a proud member of the Alliance. Our country today is the envy of many of our neighbors because of our government's competent leadership during the COVID crisis. Our economy has weathered the storm and remains healthy because of the solid stewardship we were able to provide in the form of the man who I am proud to call the next premier of the Cayman Islands. My cousin, Roy McTaggart. We have ensured that we are poised for a stronger, safer future because of the work of the progressives and our alliance partners. Now is not the time to gamble with your future. The people of Georgetown West know me. I have been a member of that community for over 60 years. I have lived and worked in that part of Georgetown all my life. My life of service began very early, based on the values my parents instilled in me. So when the people of Georgetown West put their faith in me 4 years ago, I was honored and truly humbled. Whether it has been helping to implement neighborhood watch programs in communities across Georgetown West, seeing to it that we revamped and overhauled the drainage network in Windsor Park, assisting our children with the tools they need for success, I have continued to work for you. It warms my heart when constituents reach out to say they appreciate the work I have been doing on the ground to improve the area, like the removal of derelict vehicles from our neighborhoods. This is a role I take seriously because I am here for you and have been here for you for 4 years and more. But the most satisfying aspect of the job has been my continued involvement with the youth. I am a member of the Youth Parliament Committee, helping to mold the next generation of leaders. I know the importance of giving our youth the tools for success, no matter what career path they choose. That is why I have never hesitated to support the construction class at SciFec. I am proud when I see our young Caymanians sharpening their skills to make the most of their future. Working with the Boys to Men program has also given me the opportunity to help at-risk young men
grow into productive members of society. As a former national athlete, I try to attend as many primary and high school sports days to present medals and inspire our up-and-coming athletes to continue aiming for the stars. I look forward to being a part of a progressive and alliance government for another 4 years as we overhaul social welfare legislation to better assist those in need. We will implement a community development office whose focus will be to improve the quality of life for citizens in designated low-income areas through planning and implementation of development projects and social infrastructure like housing. We will also look at more affordable public options for health insurance, home insurance, and pension plans that can exceed those offered by the private sector. As a member of a strong and committed team, I look forward to working in the interests of the people of Georgetown West and the people of the wider Cayman Islands for another 4 years. Don't be fooled by those who are appearing out of thin air and professing their love for you and your community. I have been here all along, and I'm not going nowhere. And I have said it before, and I'm copying the premier, and I will say it again. You might love Cayman as much as I do, but I can guarantee you that you will never love Cayman more than I do. The last 4 years as your elected representative has given me a bigger opportunity to be closely involved with three things that are dear to my heart: the elderly, sports, and our youth. I have been involved in Cayman politics since the early 1980s, campaigning, canvassing, and helping with political meetings. But I have never witnessed our young people being as involved and interested in a political campaign as I have witnessed leading up to this election. It has given me the most pleasure to have so many young people involved in the Progressive and Alliance election campaign, and it has encouraged me to fight even harder, because it's not me, it's about them. They are our future. We can all be proud of the way our young people have become interested in and gotten involved in Cayman's political process, and it can only be a good thing for the future of the Cayman Islands we love. I am so happy to have their support and help. And at this time, I would like to publicly thank them by asking them to join me on stage now. I'm going to call 2 minutes of my time just to ask my canvassing and campaigning young Caymanians just to join me here on stage. I want to thank them publicly. Sogoni Arteaga, Jalissa Ramon. And I know this is a name that you might hear and think somebody else, but this is Tommy Ramon. This is the young Tommy. James Jackson and Vanessa Hurlston. And I know Barbara has some young people that have been helping her as well, and I would like to see if they're here, that Barbara will call them up when they come. But I just want to thank you all so much.
Thank you too.
Thank you.
Let me see if Chris, if I can get a picture. Is he here? No, he's not here, so. Okay. If you want a stronger, safer future, stick with the man you know, the one who has always been there for you. Let us continue what we have started. So Georgetown West, when you go out to vote tomorrow, go early and put your ex next to David White, number 4 on the ballot, and I will get right back to work on your behalf. And please do not forget to vote for all the progressives and alliance candidates in your constituency. Thank you and good night.
For the progressives, serving you is the objective. We're going all the way.
Hello, Georgetown West. This is your representative, David White. This election, I'm running as a progressives candidate with the Alliance team. We have known each other long before I ran for office, and you know of my commitment to you, the people of Georgetown West. As part of a new Alliance government, I can continue to enhance our neighborhoods and improve your quality of life. Make affordable housing a reality. Ensure our children get an education and better opportunities to ensure their prosperity. I humbly ask you to vote for me, David White, number 4 on April the 14th, so that together we can continue to build a better Georgetown West and a better Cayman.
This is a paid advertisement by the Progressives.
Keep that round of applause going. He not only talks it, ladies and gentlemen, but that young man walks it and he lives it. Got a heart of gold, I'm telling you, a heart of gold. And he's done much, as he has said, for the elderly, the youth, and certainly sports. So your man in Georgetown West, Mr. David White, certainly, again, fantastic, fantastic worker. And also, again, I point out that he also served as co-chair for a committee that I have the pleasure of chairing, looking at solutions for traffic and, you know, excellent worker, hard worker. So Georgetown West, you know what you got in your public servant. Put David White in for another term. One good term deserves another. As I mentioned earlier on tonight, that I get the pleasure of playing double duty tonight, and of course I have to remind myself and my team that I'm also a candidate for Prospect, so I will share a few words particular to my constituents in Prospect, those who may be here with us tonight, as well as those who are watching live or listening live on Rooster. You know, you hear a lot of candidates, and I hear them in Prospect doing the same thing, making a great deal of promises. But I listen very carefully, particularly to my opponents, and I ask myself and I ask you, you notice how they never tell you how they're going to accomplish all of these wonderful things they're going to deliver for you? Not one of them. They tell you everything about how bad the government has done, and also how much better they are going to deliver for you, but they can never tell you exactly how they're going to do it. In 2017, I first was elected for Prospect. In 2021, I now demit the role of Member of Parliament, but I'm trusting that Prospect will re-elect me. But I can safely say, thank you, without fear or contradiction, that I leave Prospect in 2021 better than I found it in 2017. I have promised, and I have delivered, and now I promise again. I promise or pledge to Prospect to deliver in my next term a cleaner, safer, cleaner, greener, and safer Prospect. But as I said before, I'm not promising you these things without telling you how I intend to achieve it. We've done a remarkable job at dealing with traffic, particularly improving the regularity of garbage collection. For that, I thank the Department of Environmental Health and the Minister for Health, my colleague, the Honorable John Seymour. But we still have more to do. In particular, the trash that Prospect suffers from is the trash that persons who don't live in Prospect discard on their way to and through our beautiful constituency. I intend to fix that by amending the litter law, to amend the penalties that are weeded out for those lawbreakers. When's the last time anybody got fined $500 for littering in this country? Never. But certainly I believe the only way to really get the message across that we want a cleaner prospect is by hitting our litter bugs in the pocket. I don't mean killing nobody, but I mean hitting them in the pocket so they get the message that we don't want any of your trash in Prospect or anywhere. Toss it, trash it, don't toss it. And also to enforce these changes in the laws, I intend to introduce something called your litter wardens. So not only will I create people who will go out in the community and actually target those otherwise lawbreakers, but I'll also create jobs at the same time. New jobs that we don't have already. When we talk about a greener prospect, I pledge to develop more public open spaces and parks. But I also pledge to work with the Department of Agriculture to promote something that I believe in, and that is the development of community farms. A community to feed each other, since we're all eating so healthy, is what I promise to deliver for Prospect in some of the open spaces. I can only apologize, certainly together, my colleague and partner during this last 4 years in Red Bay. We tried to deliver to you the first ever brand new Red Bay and Prospect Community Park, but certainly COVID kind of took a year from us and delayed us somewhat. But as I said at our Thursday meeting, whether I'm your representative in Prospect or not, the fruits of our labor will continue to be delivered in Prospect long after I'm gone, and certainly the park in particular will be delivered, we hope, certainly by the end of the year. But again, I'm trusting that Prospect will do the right thing. Go to the polls on Wednesday, vote one and done. Go enjoy the rest of your holiday. Vote for Austin Harris. One good term deserves another. I also pledge to deliver a safer Prospect. And we have made positive strides in the last 4 years. We're the first government to introduce neighborhood community policing and an entire department for it. And we've already seen the benefits derived of our community. We've had a number of prowlers and burglars apprehended and are now facing prosecution. But that crime is only going to increase, and we need to be prepared for it. So one of the things I intend to accomplish that is vote more monies for the neighborhood community policing. That also means new jobs for young Caymanian officers who are just coming out of, you know, graduation in school, looking out for you and I when we sleep. And of course, I will also develop a comprehensive flood water management system to deal with the growing problem of flooding in Prospect proper, which has existed since before I got there, but I pledge to not depart from Prospect if you elect me before I fix that problem once and for all. And I will also fix the traffic problem both in the mornings for our residents getting out of their communities as well as everybody else east of Prospect who suffer under the frustration of daily traffic jams. But to do it, you have to re-elect me in Prospect. Just go to the polls tomorrow, vote number one, and done. Take the rest of the day off. And afterwards, send me back to work. Our next speaker, ladies and gentlemen, has also been another hard worker, particularly within her community and amongst her constituents. She is the candidate for Georgetown South. Please put your hands together and welcome my friend, Barbara Conolly.
Thank you. me, ladies and gentlemen, for another 4 years. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good evening. And a special good evening to Georgetown South. Can I hear it for Georgetown South? Yay! I am indeed excited and energized to be here with you. The past few weeks on the campaign trail have filled me with optimism. It has been my pleasure to have had the opportunity to speak to after a voter in my constituency, as I have been doing over the past 4 years. I listened to concerns about issues affecting our people and about the solutions we are planning to implement for a safer, stronger future for the Cayman Islands. It was the esteemed former U.S. First Lady, Michelle Obama, who said, and I quote, "You will not always be able to solve all of the world's problems at once, but don't ever underestimate the importance you can have, because history has shown us that courage can be contagious and hope can take on a life of its own," unquote. I mention that because our government has had the courage to take bold action to put Cayman on the path to a safer, stronger future. And at the constituency level, I have seen to it that infrastructure and other upgrades have been made in Georgetown South. But we know there is more to be done. I stand before you tonight, energized to continue to work for you as the Member of Parliament for Georgetown South. And I'm heartened by the support of my constituents. 4 years ago, I said I was ready for the challenge. Tonight, I say I am ready for the challenge of continuing to elevate the level of representation that we have been delivering to the people of the Cayman Islands. One of my first priorities after being re-elected is to see to it that we amend the legislation to get our constituency councils up and running. This will provide a forum for members of the community to set aside politics and come together to work with their MPs to identify and provide solutions that impact their communities. In addition to the various neighborhood watches that I have helped implement across Georgetown South, I will work to have more in place in other neighborhoods, because it is together, not alone, that we can achieve great things. These neighborhood watches have and will continue to provide a greater sense of community as we serve as our brothers and sisters keepers, looking out for one another and keeping our neighborhoods safe. You have heard me say before that education and looking after the needs of our young people is high on my priority list. When we get back to work after the election, I will build on the work I have been doing. That's why, after co-sponsoring school programs in Windsor Park, I will see to it that we continue to widen that scope. I will oversee the establishment of homework clubs and more after-school offerings to the young people of our community. These after-school programs will ensure that we provide as much support as we can to our children and help to ease the burden on parents. I will do the same for our seniors, providing them with opportunities to learn basic computer skills and having some place to go to interact with their peers and host social functions. An initiative I am planning to spearhead is the provision of Wi-Fi hotspots throughout Windsor Park. These Wi-Fi hotspots will allow residents to have constant access to the internet. This will also help students who need to do research for their studies, regardless of whether they have an internet connection at home. This is something I am committed to working with our telecommunication providers to put in place. I mentioned at our meeting in Windsor Park that we will work with the community to identify deserving individuals who have made their contributions over the years to be recognized and have the park there renamed in their honor. As I have done with the pond in Windsor Park, I will work with the community to spruce up more green areas in Georgetown South. My track record, ladies and gentlemen, shows that I back up my words with action. And even rolling up my sleeves and getting my hands dirty to get the job done. Along with my progressives and alliance partners, we will further improve standards in education. The most important thing in improving standards in education is to improve the quality of teaching. And that is what we have seen happening across Cayman's public schools, with inspection report after inspection report showing that the quality of teaching is improving. Much of that, of course, is down to the hard work of our teachers. I want to thank Cayman's teachers and educators tonight for their fantastic response to the challenge this government posed to them to secure improvement. But government did not just tell teachers they needed to improve and then sit back and hope that that would happen. No. We have given teachers the rewards they deserve and the support they need. To improve the quality of teaching, we need to be able to attract and retain the best graduates into the profession. And we need to ensure that Caymanians are attracted to the teaching profession. The salary increases that this government has delivered are enabling that to happen. Parents in Cayman do not want to settle for second best. They want a public school system that demands Caymanian students aim high, and that gives students all the support they need to achieve their goals. These last 4 years have begun the journey of improvement in our schools. We need to return an alliance government to office so that we can see through what we have so successfully started. If returned to office, then you know what that the day after tomorrow, the Alliance team will be back at work making Cayman's public schools better. We have the plans in place and we are ready to go. We need to finish what the Alliance has started. A vote for the Alliance candidates, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow is a vote to continue the journey of improvement. A vote to continue to improve the quality of teaching. A vote to carry on implementing the curriculum changes that will allow our students to aim higher about to see further improvements in the exam results that our students achieve, and a vote to see every Caymanian child taught in a public school rated at least good by our inspectors. We will extend technical and vocational education training to new service and knowledge-based sectors. As part of our plan to prepare our children for the world of work, high school students will receive early career guidance to ensure that they are aware of the benefits of various professions and jobs. We will work with the private sector to provide a wider variety of internships to open our children's eyes to a wide range of career possibilities and ensure they have the opportunity to get the right skills to go with those jobs. We will continue the school building improvements we have started and plan forward for new primary school space as demand increases. And in these plans, schools will develop wired classrooms to use technology for teaching and every child to have the technology needed to benefit. As we seek to improve the situation with traffic, we have identified the issues and are working to address them. One suggestion under consideration is encouraging private schools to use buses. If they can do this, possibly with a partial grant from government, this will help reduce the bottlenecks that we see on Smith Road, Walker's Road, Fairbanks, and others. This would also help ease the flow of traffic into Georgetown in the peak morning hours. As we improve the overall public transportation infrastructure, this will help ease the congestion during rush hour. In healthcare, we will review the effectiveness and viability of a modern health insurance system that includes a national health insurance plan alongside options for private insurance. Additionally, we will explore other avenues to provide affordable health care for our seniors and free medical services for all children. The impacts on mental health of our people are becoming more apparent each day. That's why, in addition to advancing the good work that has gone into the creation of a new mental health facility in East End, we will see to it that the necessary resources are put in place to allow our young people, in particular, have access to the necessary specialty services. This will help identify and address any issues they have and better position them for success in the future. Many of my constituents have spoken to me about housing. One of the initiatives that we will be putting in place is to work with local banks to introduce an updated government-guaranteed home assistance mortgage scheme, or GGHAM, and promote the Build on Your Own Land scheme. We will also incentivize developers to build more affordable home rental and home ownership schemes alongside that of the National Housing Development Trust. Before I wrap up, ladies and gentlemen, I want to say a special thank you to those of you here tonight from Georgetown South. Your support over the last 6 weeks of this campaign has been magnificent. And the enthusiasm you have shown and hard work you have put in has been absolutely inspirational. I thank you all for everything that you have done to support my campaign. I also want to thank the young people that actually assisted me in my canvassing. I don't know if they're here tonight, but if they are, y'all can come forward in just a minute. And I recognize just how important your support has been. Make no mistake, we are in a fight in Georgetown South. But it is a fight I know we can win. With your continued help tomorrow, with one more big push to turn out the support for the alliance that we know is there in Georgetown South, it is a fight I know we will win tomorrow. As we get set to vote tomorrow, we must keep in mind that we need to ensure a stronger, safer future for our people. That's why we cannot, ladies and gentlemen, we cannot afford to gamble with a mix of people who have no cohesive plan. The Progressives and our alliance partners have a strong team with a clear leader and a track record of high-quality leadership based on integrity and sound economic decisions. I encourage the voters of Georgetown South to look at my track record of service to the community and know that I have been there for you, showing genuine care, not just showing up for photo ops. That is not my style. Some of my supporters have told me that my opponent is not popular in the constituency. He didn't even get 100 votes last time, they say, and they tell me not to worry about the election. But we must not fall into the trap of complacency. Every vote will matter tomorrow. So I urge everyone in Georgetown South who supports me and supports the Alliance to come out and vote tomorrow. If you want me to continue to represent you and fight for you, come out and vote. If you want to see our alliance government continue, come out and vote. If you want to see our plans for the country put into action, come out and vote. Elections don't get won by folks sitting at home and thinking everything will be all right. Elections get won by folks turning out and voting. Tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow, please go out early to the polling station and cast your vote for a stronger, safer future for the Cayman Islands. Vote for Barbara Conolly. I'm proud to be a progressive, and I'm proud to stand as a member of the Alliance and as the representative for Georgetown South. Vote for the woman who has been with you for the past 4 years, working. Working hard for you, ladies and gentlemen. Working hard every day of those 4 years, working for the people of Georgetown South. I'm a trusted, tried, and tested representative of the people. I stand ready to continue representing the people of Georgetown South in our parliament. And I'm looking forward to your vote tomorrow. Vote Barbara Conolly, number one on your ballot paper. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. God bless you, and God bless these beautiful Cayman Islands.
Serving you is the objective. Friends and voters of Georgetown South, this is Barbara Conolly, your Progressives and Alliance candidate. Over the last 4 years, I have worked diligently to make Georgetown South a better place to live. I rededicate myself to the betterment of all my constituents as a member of a new government, a government that has workable plans and programs to safely reopen our country and create greater employment opportunities for our young people. An Alliance government will provide affordable housing, grow our economy, and look after our elderly and vulnerable families. I ask you to vote for Barbara Conolly on the 14th of April, 2021, so that with God's help, I may continue to serve you.
This is a paid promotion by the Progressives.
Put your hands ready, Progressives, serving you.
Barbara Conolly, ladies and gentlemen, your candidate for Georgetown South. Certainly, her commitment to the elderly is unmatched, and it is our hope, and I'm grateful to also say, thanks to the efforts of the Ministry of Community Affairs, the elderly that she cares so much about now have a brand new active aging center, which will be intended to deliver valuable services to the elderly exclusively. And I know certainly the member will have good use of that building in the future. I also want to thank her for what she pointed out in terms of the important milestones in education. The reality, my friends, you won't be able to measure, and this is a fact. Don't just take my word for it, but it's a fact. You won't be able to truly measure the successes in education in a four-year period. It takes much, much longer than that. But as she pointed out, each school inspection report continues to get better, highlighting, of course, this government and previous government's commitment to education. And I also believe the policies implemented under this administration will prove, in fact, to be the right decisions for our children in the future. So we have members like Barbara Conolly to thank for their contributions in that regard. And we're also thankful that she also mentioned some of the plans going forward for mental illness and mental health. Certainly the mental illness center, as well as the need for development of housing, are very important issues that hasn't fallen off of this team's radar. And certainly when you elect the Alliance in 2021 tomorrow, we will continue to deliver those very important pieces of infrastructure. Before we move on to some of the heavy hitters of this evening's meeting, I want us to pause and take a look back at from whence we come. At one of our meetings, we had the pleasure of delivering a COVID poem put together by Blue Serenity. I believe it takes a look at from whence we came in this COVID pandemic to how far we have moved forward, accomplishing a feat that not very many places in this world have been able to accomplish, and it's being proven by this audience here tonight. But certainly I want you to enjoy and sit back and enjoy a walk down memory lane that's just a year old from Blue Serenity. Please enjoy this COVID poem.
Blue Serenity in yonder deep, the fear of death, but you pray, O Lord, for your soul to keep. Dear boredom, nothing but a selfish film over our eyes. Some people just don't get it. COVID-19 is a murderer, and your defiance reflects upon your character. Yes, I get it. Cabin fever is a breeding ground for depression, but I have a confession. Yes, you guessed it. We are in this together, and although our stories are not the same, they're similar enough to understand the pain. Read a book. Engage your mind. Don't give negativity the time to fester. Don't let it rule you so that Cayman too can see this through. Those beloved smiles that we shared with friends doesn't have to end. But you are consumed by what you do not have. When the health of Cayman is in your hands, there are many without work. They can't go to Kirk's in a panic, worry about organic. Premier says to live frugally so that repercussions don't hit so brutally. Read a book, they say. However, it is true, to discover something your mind never knew, educational absorbency in this time of uncertainty, together, Cayman, together. Together, let's stay home, not just you alone. This is not a punishment, but a journey to success, to restore our faith in the human touch and the beauty of shared air. Together, we are a nation. Together, we are stronger.
Again, a round of applause for that beautiful, beautiful video poem, which was written by Miss Tahiti Seymour, who I believe is a relative of Minister? Daughter of our Minister, John, in Bordentown East. Certainly, I want to also extend apologies for our colleagues in Bordentown East, Bordentown West, Miss and Newland, certainly. Minister John Seymour, Mr. Vincent Frederick, and our colleague Alva Suku certainly wanted to be here with us this evening, but because of the hustings on the Eastern Districts, they decided to do something together. But certainly we are one team, one alliance, and we're asking your vote on Wednesday, the 14th. Also, before we move back into the politics, we want to change gears a little bit. When we were getting ready tonight, the music was playing and I saw a number of people in the audience dancing, and they gave me the suggestion that they wanted to party a little bit. So I'm going to give you the opportunity, if your bum's a little sore, to get up and dance and enjoy yourself to some fantastic entertainment. I want to welcome to the stage to perform two songs. Please put your hands together for the very, very talented Mr. Andy Blake, ladies and gentlemen. Andy Blake.
Stories been told about how we came to be swashbuckling pirates on the raging seas, looking for plunder, looking for gold. Come to a place that I call home. Woo! Sweet little island in the sea, enchanted islands for you and me. I said, we have found it upon the seas, enchanted islands, come with me. Yeah, yeah. I want you to come with me to my island, call me free. Give thanks to that people. Feel the cool breeze. Oh, 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 yeah. Over and over, over again. People come and they can't forget. Sand beaches, sunsets, endless cuisine. This is an enchanted island, got to be seen, yeah.
You gotta come here.
Sweet little islands in the sea, enchanted islands for you and me. I said, he has found it upon the seas, enchanted islands, come with me. Yeah, yeah. I want you to come with me.
One of the most best places on this earth.
My island is
the Cayman Islands. I'm proud to be called a Caymanian. You guys who know this song.
This is the place you all love to be. This is my roots, my ancestry.
I said, no, I'm from the Cayman Islands, the smallest place on the map. I want to thank you all for making this island very blessed to us, a sacred place. Thank you very, very much. Yeah? This government has given me a chance to showcase my talent and so many other young people. And for that, we thank you very much.
We thank you. We thank you.
Sweet, sweet Cayman. Sweet, sweet Cayman. Sweet, sweet Cayman. My island's in the sea. Yeah. Yeah. I want you to come with me.
Sweet, sweet Cayman Islands. Sweet, sweet Cayman Islands. Woo! Yeah, man. I got next one for you guys. You might like this one too. You never know how me did this one. Get up if you can, get up please. You're here for your representatives, right? You're here for the candidates, the progressives. Cayman stronger now. Cayman stronger now. Say Cayman stronger now. They seem stronger now. If you want the same thing, I love what I'm having right now. Nowhere on earth we can have this. They had the right objective. We're going all the way. Progressive all the way. I say, stronger, safer, Cayman. Stronger, safer, Cayman. This is our plan. For each and everyone. For all Cayman. Serving you is the objective. We're going all the way. Progressive all the way. I say, have a good night. My name is Andy Blake.
Keep that round of applause going for Andy Blake. Party, party, party. Cayman got some serious talent, don't you agree? And all we got to do, like the young man said, is give them a chance, and they will do all the shining for us. Andy Blake, ladies and gentlemen, wow, what a fantastic talent, what a fantastic talent. Well, keeping the show rolling along, your next speaker for the evening has certainly been on the go this past 4 years. He has been resurfacing roads. He has been building roads. He has been expanding roads. All in an attempt to improve your morning and your evening traffic commute. But he's also been concerned with ensuring that those impacted by COVID and certainly those who have been displaced have also had a place in which they can count on, a place in which they can fall back on. Please put your hands together and welcome the only candidate in Georgetown North you need to pay any attention to. On the go, Joe, Minister Joe.
What a feeling, what a spirit. Andy Blake really know how to hurt a man, but I want to get up and dance, but I only got 1 foot. I can't even do a little wind down. I know, I hear you, Sophie, I hear you. I love you too, Dina Rose, I love you too. Good evening, good evening. It's great to see so many of you turning out once again to support your alliance candidates for tomorrow elections. As I look out I see a lot of familiar faces, especially from Georgetown North. It's great to see you all, and I thank you for your support, not just in the last few weeks, but over the last several years. Georgetown is a home field for the progressives, and many of you out here tonight have been the backbone of our team for 20 years, and I thank you all for your continued support. However, an important part of this campaign has been the progressives and the alliance, and we have been growing in support. I want to extend a special welcome to those who are new to the party, and perhaps those even new to politics altogether. It's great to have you here with us tonight. Talking to voters in Georgetown North, it has become clear to me why people will be turning out and voting for the alliance tomorrow. First, of course, they recognize our achievements as a government. Top of list in Georgetown North is that we are the people who have finally fixed the dump. That's right. Everyone can see the capping that has already taken place, and the contract that was signed just a couple weeks ago guarantees a long-term solution that will end this country's reliance on landfilling for good. It is a huge achievement for the current government and for the country. Certainly, I notice the deafening silence now from those who answered every question with, fix the dump, fix the dump. Well, you don't have any more answers, but we still can answer the questions. To be honest, capping the landfill might have been enough on its own for many of my constituents, but they can also point to our handling of the pandemic and the support that we have provided to those in need during the crisis. Parents can see the improvement in schools. The families of seafarers and veterans welcome the increases that have seen stipends nearly doubled. And small business owners recognize the financial and business support they have received that has helped to keep their businesses afloat. The voters in Georgetown North know that if they want the track record of strong, effective government to continue, then they need to get out and vote for me, Joey Hew, and the Alliance tomorrow. But there is even more to that than that. Voters in Georgetown North are smart people. They understand the value of experience, and they trust politicians who have a track record of delivering what they have promised. And I don't mean those promises that were made recently by others of Popeye's chicken. What a bunch of amateurs. They don't know that Georgetown North like McDonald's chicken better. But I also understand that voters in Georgetown North don't want politicians who just try to trade on past glories. They want a government with a clear vision for the future and a real plan for how they can deliver the vision that they set out. Voters in Georgetown North agree with the Alliance vision for a stronger, safer future for Cayman. And they, go ahead, applaud. And they have listened to our plans to achieve that vision, and I can tell you what, they like what they hear. Yes, you love what you hear. They want to see the safe opening up of the economy, and they understand the Alliance plan will bring back jobs and business opportunities for Caymanians. They want their children to be educated in good schools, and they see how the Alliance will continue the reforms in education that we have begun. They want to look after the environment, and they have welcomed the Alliance plans for public transport, renewable energy, and millions of dollars of new investment in sustainable development projects. Voters have listened to the Alliance plans, and they like what they hear. But they also listen to our opponents, and like me, they have become increasingly worried by what they have heard. Now, one of the things about elections is that they are the time when folks who like the sound of their own voices need to finally put up or shut up. They cannot continue to just sit around in coffee shops and call into the talk shows, preaching about all the government has gotten wrong. No. Come election time, you have to convince voters that you can do things better. And because the light now turns on the opposition, everyone can see for themselves that they do not have the answers necessary to meet the challenges facing Cayman. As we have pointed out throughout this campaign, the Alliance is the only team with a comprehensive national plan for the government. It is a realistic plan, and it is a plan that we will deliver. Most of the candidates just have uncoordinated ideas or sets of proposals for particular subjects or for their particular constituency. Certainly my opponent in Georgetown North is a good example of such a scattergun campaigner. But he is also a good example of why voters are turning their backs on the ideas and the proposals being put forward by independents with no experience. During the Chamber of Commerce debate, my opponent sneered when I talked about Plan Cayman and commented, it appears to be the answer to everything. I don't say it's the answer to everything, but the last time we had a national plan was way back in 1997. Our islands have changed drastically in the last 20-odd years. Every attempt by previous administrations to update the National Development Plan has failed. It has failed because the total task is too large. You can't get everyone to agree, and it just takes too long. The Plan Cayman approach is the best opportunity we have had in decades to make a start of a national plan by doing sections of Grand Cayman at a time, completing all of Grand Cayman over 5 years, and then starting over. In other words, it's a rolling development plan process, and it will be completed. This is an inclusive plan that will garner feedback from people who live in the areas, so they have invested and they are invested in the outcomes. The ministry has already completed work in the Seven Mile Beach area, and once the elections are over, public consultation will begin. It means that the people who live in the Seven Mile Beach will have a say in how they want their area to look, including property development and green spaces. The next area will be the Georgetown area. Affordable housing is a topic that many of you have raised with me. During this last term, this administration increased stamp duty thresholds for first-time Caymanian homebuyers, allowing more Caymanians to purchase first-time properties of land duty-free or at 2% duty. I am delighted that this government over the last 4 years has helped over 1,200 Caymanians buy their first home through the first-time Caymanian owner's plan. Ladies and gentlemen, this equates to over $19 million in stamp duty waived by this government. But we want to do more. Our plans that are once elected as an alliance government, we will pursue the re-implementation of the government-guaranteed home assistance mortgage plan. In the past, this program has helped many Caymanians achieve their dreams of building their own home and property and owning their own property. And we also intend, as our manifesto states, to look at as many options for affordable housing as we can, including affordable rentals. On page 17 of our manifesto, we highlight supporting Caymanians to own their own homes. Push forward the National Housing Development Trust's affordability housing program, build new homes in East End and Bodentown, purchase 4 acres of land in Georgetown for additional NHDT affordable homes, and all new homes will incorporate solar panels to help save on electricity costs. Increased stamp duty thresholds for first-time Caymanian homebuyers, allowing greater numbers of Caymanians to purchase first-time properties and land duty-free or at 2% duty. We supported the government-guaranteed home assistance mortgage program that has assisted over 300 families obtain homes over the years. The program fell away in 2020, but is being re-implemented. I mentioned earlier the capping of the Georgetown landfill as a huge move forward for our country. This administration and the previous one have been working for the last 8 years to get a permanent fix, and thankfully, that contract has now been signed. The implementation of the new integrated solid waste management system facility will deliver a waste-to-energy solution that will remove 95% of waste that currently goes into our landfill and turn it into energy to be used by CUC for generating electricity. And they say we don't do anything for the environment. What did you say, it was a lie? They lie. We all know that climate change is one of the biggest threats to our natural environment. And that's why we've pushed forward with our transition to sustainable energy, including solar. Our goal is to have 10% of electricity generated by a combination of rooftop solar and CUC's solar energy plant by 2023. I want us to increase the renewable targets and achieve it even faster. And that is certainly my ambition. One of the things we have committed to in the manifesto is to ensure that all new National Housing Development Trust homes are built to include solar panels, and we will look to include rooftop solar onto the government buildings. We've also committed to banning single-use plastic and straws within our first year in office. I'd like to speak about micro and small businesses. They are the lifeblood of our economy. Bringing forward the opening of the Business Development Center has meant that this government is providing help to businesses, while it also means that those small businesses that need premises can now take advantage of the incubator units we have established. The next Alliance government will extend the support available. Working with the Chamber of Commerce and the Small Business Association, we can create a world-class support network to enable Caymanian entrepreneurs to thrive in the economic recovery that we know can be achieved. As the country returns to economic growth, we must also maintain the pace of the infrastructure investments that the current government has achieved. Just pause for a moment and reflect on just how significant the government's transformation in Cayman's public infrastructure has been, even during the pandemic. Airport terminal and runway improvements delivered, beach improvements at the public beach, Coalwood Beach and Kaibo Beach, road network enhancements, including the delivery and the start of the East-West Arterial Road and the associated local improvements that will ease the congestion problems coming into Georgetown at peak hours. New public open spaces, including the South Sound Boardwalk, the Nature Park on Bel Air Drive, delivered, and schemes underway for the Scranton Community Park and a new park for Red Bay, Eastern Avenue, and Prospect. New high schools built, and classrooms and sports pitch enhancements for primary schools delivered. The new long-term residential mental health facility is on its way to completion. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a government that gets things done. This is a government with a plan. Two further infrastructure improvements are promised in our manifesto that I want to highlight. First, I am delighted that we are now seeing real progress with Georgetown revitalization. A lot of ground with stakeholders to build confidence and to build consensus. The recent request for proposals for a range of physical improvements to the central business area is a significant step forward for the project. The Alliance Manifesto commits the next government to following through with the delivery of these much-needed improvements. This will include things that government would deliver directly, such as improved streets that include enhanced provisions for walking and cycling, new lighting schemes, the addition of more trees to create shade areas, and new green spaces for leisure and enjoyment, all in our town center. But it also involves leveraging the partnerships we have now developed with other stakeholders. That means working with the business community, retailers, and hospitality industry to return activities to the center of Georgetown at evenings and weekends. Events we have put on have demonstrated that there is a demand, but we need to consolidate that by encouraging and incentivizing the building of mixed-use residential and commercial buildings that will bring people back into the town. Only the Alliance has both the plans and the partnerships in place to deliver this ambitious scheme to revitalize our nation's capital. The other improvement I want to highlight at this point, less well advanced, but it's nonetheless important for our future. That is a commitment the Alliance is making to a new public transport solution for Grand Cayman. As I have said, we have begun and we will complete the road network improvements that are necessary to ease Cayman's current traffic congestion problems. But building more road capacity is not the long-term answer. Not the least because it simply increases the pollution and environmental issues caused by our resilience on our individual private cars. However, people will not reduce the use of their cars without a reliable and an affordable alternative being available. That is why we need a new public transport solution for the island. To achieve that, we will need to look at the various options that are available, and we will need to consult with the current bus operators, the public as a part of this process. Getting the right solution that people will be ready to use might be a difficult process, but the next Alliance government will work to identify and then we will implement that solution. Ladies and gentlemen, that is what the Alliance government is really all about. Practical solutions to the challenges facing Cayman. Practical solutions in infrastructure and transport. Practical support for small businesses. And unlike our opponents, practical help for the tourism industry and not reducing its funding. Ladies and gentlemen, are we willing to risk electing a group of unorganized, inexperienced persons with wild ideas to take this country forward for the next 4 years? I say no, we are not. Caymanians are practical people. We have been this way throughout our 500-year history. You do not grow and prosper on three rocks in the middle of the Caribbean with few natural resources, without learning how to solve practical problems. There is only one team at this election that has practical plans that are ready to implement and that will achieve the stronger, safer future Cayman needs. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the Progressives Alliance team. And I don't have to tell you tonight, all of you here, those in the cars, those of you listening at home, that there's only one way that you can make sure that those plans get taken up and actually implemented. And that is to vote for your Progressives Alliance candidate tomorrow. So tomorrow, if you live in Georgetown North, get out and vote for Joey Hew. If you live elsewhere, get out and vote for your Progressive and Alliance candidate. We need to see all 11 of the Alliance candidates in office to secure the strong, stable, and effective government that this country needs and this country deserves. Our opponents range from those who have nothing to offer to those who would actually do the country harm. Now, with the COVID crisis not yet passed, and with an economy recovering to be secured, now is not the time to take a chance. Now is not the time to take a chance on untested candidates. And now is not the time to take a chance on uncertain leadership. Now is the time for experience and trusted leadership. Now is the time for the progressives and the alliance. Tomorrow morning, bright and early, Georgetown North. Who are you going to vote for? Joey? Number one on the postal ballot. Vote for. And the rest of Cayman, if you have a progressive candidate, if you have an alliance candidate, get out there and support them. Mark your X for them so that we can hit the ground running when we form the government on April 15th. Thank you all and good night.
Put your X for the progressive.
My fellow Georgetown North constituents, this is Joseph Hew. April 14th will be a landmark day as we look to elect a new government that has the experience and the competence to overcome the ravages of the pandemic. You will have the duty and the privilege of deciding who you wish to guide our country's affairs at a critical time in our development. I submit that experience and a credible plan is what the country needs now to keep us on the right track to recovery and eventually prosperity for all. The Progressives-led Alliance has a track record and a sound plan to keep us safe and take us forward. I am humbly asking you, Georgetown North, to vote for me, Joseph Hew, number one, on April 14th, so that I can have the honor of being your representative once more and continue to play a key role in the country's recovery.
We're going all the way. Progressives all the way. All right.
Applause going for your candidate on the go, Joe, as well as the rest of your alliance members. Important infrastructure solutions and practical solutions. You just heard the minister talk to you about what has been delivered as well as what will be delivered. Much progress has been made on a much-needed mental health facility. We've got new and improved roads. We got more new spaces for classrooms so we can educate the next generation. He's absolutely right. This is the government that gets things done. You know, before we introduce the next speaker, I've been talking to you a little bit about how some of our opponents are planning to actually deliver on some of the fantastic promises in which they have made. And I forgot to ask the most important of all the how questions, and it's not even a how, it's a who. Who are they going to do it with? Who are they going to work with to accomplish these mammoth plans? What I've discovered in 4 years being elected is that you need at least one friend in government to even bring a proposal. And you need 10 more friends to pass that solution and introduce change. Well, your alliance, I have 12 strong. We can certainly form the next government and deliver more practical solutions for this country. We've also heard, I think, 5 or 6 different proposals for who will very well be the next premier. But we haven't heard definitively again what team structures they will work with and again how they will accomplish it. This team, your alliance team, the only team in this election who not only have represented to you in very all transparency, who our members will be, who our hierarchy will be, what our issues will be, but we also tell you who our leader will be. Please put your hands together as we welcome the next premier of the Cayman Islands and the leader of the alliance government to come. Your friend and mine, your current Minister of Finance, the Minister, Honorable Roy McTaggart. you notice I was careful to never, ever step in front of Roy McTaggart when he's getting his boogie on. But I just want a quick public service announcement. License plate 196310, 196310. Don't know the make or model, but your lights are on in the Compass parking lot. Minister Roy McTaggart, put your hands together.
Let's have the music, please. This evening, Cayman. Thank you so much. Thank you for such a warm welcome. You know, we are at the end and on the cusp of a new election tomorrow morning. But throughout the last 4 to 6 weeks, I have just felt the momentum building. And each time we have a rally, we find that more and more people are getting involved, are attending and coming out. And you know what? The mood is positive. People are ready for the progressives and the alliance to be returned to office. So I thank you all tonight for the support. It's great to see so many of you out here in support of the progressives and our alliance members. Many hundreds of you. But I need to hear from the cars in the surrounding areas. Let's hear some horns. That don't sound good enough. You can do it better than that. Come on, everyone. Wonderful, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for responding. Ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you something for certain tonight. There is no other campaign or rally taking place in this country on the eve of this election with such a large crowd as what is here with us tonight. Congratulations and thank you. I thank you for turning out tonight in support of your progressives and alliance candidates. I am grateful and overwhelmed by the support we have received since launching our campaign just 4 short weeks ago. It's been truly humbling for me to see so many get involved, and I thank you all for your help and support of all the candidates on the Alliance team. I ask you to carry this momentum forward for one more day and keep encouraging your friends and family to vote for the Alliance. And if you're able to assist your neighbors to get to the polling stations tomorrow if they need a ride. Ladies and gentlemen, this election is going to be won on election day. For many of these constituencies, they are going to be won or lost by the thinnest of margins. Every vote needs to be counted. So promise me this evening, promise me that you're going to go out and vote tomorrow morning. Polls open at 7 a.m. You need to be there. Get it done early. But promise me, too, that you're going to ask your friends and your family and all your acquaintances who you know can vote to get out and vote. Cast that vote. It was your loyalty that helped this government pull the country out of debt, keep you safe in the midst of a pandemic, and have enough cash reserves to assist those most impacted by the shutdown of the tourism economy. Tomorrow is a big day. Once again, please show your support for the Alliance and vote, vote, vote. With your help, we can do it again. And if we win, you win too. You know, 4 to 6 weeks since we began this campaign, and we are still the only group of candidates in this election that can actually form a government. Probably some 40 plus independents running. And those who are opposing us are in no position to do so. In simple terms, there would have to be at least 10 independents to win their respective seats in order to supplant this alliance. This means all their egos and criticisms and reckless promises will have to coalesce into one body and select one leader when at least five of them all have aspirations competing for the leadership position, that of the Premier. Ladies and gentlemen, it's crazy. It's crazy what they're doing. Ask yourself for a minute, what if Cayman was a Fortune 500 company with $1 billion in annual earnings? Which of these independent candidates tonight would you hire, much less trust, to be your CEO? Not a one. I can tell you there is only one, and that is Roy McTaggart tonight. Do you really think tonight, ladies and gentlemen, that the varied egos amongst the independent challengers have any new ideas or shared beliefs to offer? Do you want candidates who will try to make a point, or a candidate who is going to make a difference? To me, the choice is clear. The alliance has come too far and built such trust and investor confidence for you to risk a government consisting of individual persons, each pursuing their own agenda. Many of the independent candidates already have what is known as political elbow, which is brought on by repeatedly patting themselves on the back while covering their backsides. Country can't afford that. And I can assure you, the EU would have a field day and place the number one pillar of our economy under great threat. We need a government with a clear vision for the future and that has the cooperation of all members of the government. Only the alliance tonight offers such stability and leadership to provide a stronger, safer future for the people of the Cayman Islands. The alliance is the only functioning group ready to govern Cayman and ready to meet the head-on challenges we know we are faced that are facing the country. And we have the track record to prove it. In fact, listen to this. In an editorial, the Cayman Compass recently concluded, after analysing the Progressives' 2017 manifesto, they said this: despite losing almost a year to COVID-19 restrictions and having to shift policies to focus on the pandemic, the Progressives appear to have worked through most of their agenda. What an endorsement. We not only keep our promises, ladies and gentlemen, but actually have that track record of delivery over two successive terms. That's performance. That's leadership. That's trust, and we have built that up over these past 8 years. You know, manifesto doesn't mean anything, or it has no meaning if it doesn't manifest. Our manifesto is a pledge and a comfort to many who know we will follow through on our promises and commitments. Just over 2 weeks ago, we launched our manifesto that sets out in detail the plan that the next alliance government will use as a roadmap to deliver on our vision for a stronger, safer future. Tonight, mere hours away from the polls opening, we are still the only group running with a clear plan for the next 4 years. So who are you going to trust? We kept our promises over the past 8 years and pledged to do so again. We have no time to boast. We have to lead. We cannot be content to be reactionary. We live in a fast-paced, unforgiving global economy that demands leadership and being proactive in anticipating new regulatory frameworks and other external stimuli that will impact Cayman and the economy. The choice for voters tonight is quite simple. Either vote for the alliance and you will get proven experience, stable and effective government that has a strong track record of delivering on the priorities the country needs, or you can risk on your safety, the economy, opening up of our borders, and dealing with the existential threats to Cayman's top producing industry. A vote for the alliance means you know who will be the premier day after tomorrow. Do I need to remind you who that person will be? But I will ask you, who is it going to be? Just call them first name. Yes. But seriously, ladies and gentlemen, I have to tell you, I am truly humbled. Humbled by the confidence placed in me by my colleagues and the progressives who have selected me as their new political leader. I'm proud to accept the challenge, knowing that I have the full support of the most experienced and capable group of candidates ever to put itself before the Cayman electorate. That's what we bring tonight to this election. So when we pledge that we will complete the promises made in our manifesto, you can trust us tonight to deliver on those promises. And when the Alliance says it will get on and vaccinate the majority of Cayman's population so that we can be confident in opening up our borders again, you know we're going to make it happen. It was our Premier and the Alliance Cabinet members who took the action necessary to avoid the public health catastrophe that has befallen so many other countries. And we didn't lose a single Caymanian to this outbreak. And we've been saying it all throughout this campaign. You know you can trust us to put lives ahead of profits. When the Alliance pledges it will open the tourism industry safely and still target the return to the 500,000 arrivals level in 3 years or less, you can be confident tonight we're going to make this happen. It was, in fact, our very own Minister of Tourism who got visitor arrivals to those record levels in the first place. He can be trusted, along with the Alliance government, to get Cayman's tourism industry back where it was. When the Alliance says it will continue to invest in key infrastructure promises, you can take that tonight to the bank. All across government and throughout the country, we have been modernising Cayman's ageing and sometimes failing infrastructure. The airport terminal has now been completed, and the John Gray High School and the new long-term health facility are nearing completion. The east-west arterial road is being expanded as I speak. And again, we finally fixed it up. You can trust the Alliance to make the right decisions. And you can trust us to prioritize the investment needed in infrastructure projects without overspending and certainly not borrowing. When the Alliance says it will restore unemployment, trust us. Over the last two terms, we have delivered consistent levels of economic growth that provided nearly 3,000 new jobs for Caymanians, which had the effect of lowering our unemployment level by more than half. We can do it again tonight, ladies and gentlemen, given the opposition, the opportunity. We make a promise that every Caymanian child will attend a public school rated good or better by the end of the next four-year term. It was our Minister of Education who finally got a grip on the systematic problems with education, who then carried out a baseline assessment of schools and created the new legislative framework necessary to carry out and deliver the reforms that were needed. The standard of teaching is improving. Exam results are improving. You know you can trust the Alliance to make every school in Cayman better than ever. Continuity is important for Cayman and for our children's future. The only alternative to carrying out the Alliance education reform agenda is to stop and start over. And believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, there are candidates standing for election tomorrow who are advocating precisely that approach. What they do not understand is that you can avoid reality, but not the consequences of avoiding reality. Education has been one of those political footballs over the years. And finally, after 8 years of introspection and hard work, things are now going in the right direction. It would be reckless to throw that all away tonight. We need to persevere for the sake of our children and the country's future workforce. The only way tonight that we can have the continuity in education is for you to vote for Alliance candidates. So vote, vote, vote. I want to turn now and take the opportunity tonight to highlight three of the new ideas contained in our 2021 manifesto. I will be very brief with you. First, we will establish a market-leading blue-green investment fund. We have already started discussions with the industry here in Cayman as well as in London. And I am happy to report that there is real appetite for such a vehicle. The benefits to Cayman will be significant. First and foremost, the fund will guarantee that millions of dollars of new investment will flow into sustainable development projects in Cayman. This will mean much needed inward investment and new business opportunities for Caymanian entrepreneurs, along with a host of new opportunities for hundreds of Caymanians. This type of fund will change the image and the perception of Cayman and its financial services industry. Finally, I believe that we'll be able to promote Cayman and our financial services industry in a very positive light and send a strong message to those who are trying to do us harm that we are nothing like the persona of Cayman that is portrayed in the movies. Secondly, the Alliance will develop and implement a new skills strategy for Cayman as we look to diversify Cayman's economy, particularly into areas such as digital and knowledge-based industries, including health sciences and other intellectual property. There will be job opportunities that will require new skills, and unless Caymanians can acquire those skills, labour will once more need to be imported. So we have to prepare our people for these opportunities that we know are coming our way. Our skills strategy will look ahead and identify the skills required of the future workforce and put programs in place that will equip our workforce across all ages with the tools necessary to be competitive in the jobs market of the future. If we are to continue to be number one in the Caribbean and have international respect, we also need to have the most capable and educated workforce. We must prepare for our future. Remember, it wasn't raining when Noah built the ark. Think about it. Thirdly, the Alliance brings a new cross-government approach to affordable housing. We put in place a number of initiatives that assisted Cayman families in purchasing their own home. My colleague Joy mentioned the statistics just now. More than 1,200 Caymanians benefiting from the first Caymanian homeowners purchase program. $19.4 million in stamp duties waived. That's $19.4 million in the pockets of Caymanians today that they would not normally have had. We pledge to improve on the record and recognize that there is still more that can be done, not the least of which is to tackle the problem of affordable rents. Currently, responsibilities are scattered across government, so we have identified the need to bring all of these responsibilities together, and to achieve this, we are going to be appointing a new parliamentary secretary to focus solely on affordable housing. With the right political direction and leadership, we can achieve this. And affordable housing represents a much-needed opportunity for us to make a real difference for Caymanians. Folks, I said this at the beginning, but I am absolutely proud tonight to have been chosen to lead the Progressives, an earmark to be the next Premier, to lead a group of experienced candidates. To be able to lead a group of experienced candidates that have shown they can deliver is indeed a privilege for me. I know I can count on my team, and together we will deliver for Cayman. You know, others tonight may criticize us, but a good soundbite is not the same as good sound policy. It's now up to you to turn out in massive numbers and vote tomorrow overwhelmingly to elect the 12 proven leaders that makes up this alliance. And when I talk about experience, let me just remind you of one fact. That of the 12 candidates that we are associated with, the Progressives and the Alliance, 10 of us already have years of experience in government. There is no one, no matter what grouping they come up with, could even begin to come close to what experience we bring to the table in leading this country. As I've said before too, ladies and gentlemen, having the best team doesn't always guarantee you the win. The difference is that we are your managers tonight, and it is your game to win or lose. Just one more day to go, and we trust and pray and hope that we'll all get it right. The future of our islands depends on the return of the Alliance government. So pick your CEOs for your $1 billion company, and you will. And with your hard work, we will secure the election for the 12 Alliance candidates, and we will form the next government on Thursday. And we will be ready to get back to work on Friday, or as soon as we can get the governor to swear us all in. That's performance, ladies and gentlemen. That's unity. So let me hear the horns. Finally tonight, ladies and gentlemen, all of us up here on the stage tonight and in other districts pledge to roll up our sleeves and get back to the job of running the country with confidence. Each of us eagerly looks forward to doing so. I leave you with this. Tomorrow is the day. The Alliance is the way. To make sure that the next 4 years are well spent, don't vote independent. Get out and vote, vote, vote. And thank you all for your continued support and trust. This has been an incredible journey these past 4 to 6 weeks. But here we are again on the cusp of a new election that will determine the fate and the future of this country for the next 4 years. I ask you prayerfully, choose wisely, make the right choices, and let's choose Progressives and our Alliance members. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a pleasure to be with you, and I wish us all Godspeed tomorrow. Get out early and vote, too, for Georgetown Central, Georgetown East. Almost forgot. Vote number 5, Roy McTaggart. Thank you all.
This is Roy McTaggart, and I have a personal message for my constituents in Georgetown East. This election will determine the future prosperity of the Cayman Islands for many years to come. How we manage our affairs in this time of crisis will determine the success of our national recovery and the quality of life for us all. As leader of the Progressives-led Alliance, I give you my personal undertaking to continue to be decisive but caring, to bring new opportunities for these islands while making sure that no one is left behind. In order to do this, I really need your vote on April 14th. I pledge to continue to protect lives and restore livelihoods. With your vote, it will be my honor to represent you once more. I therefore ask you to vote for Roy McTaggart, number 5.
This is a paid promotion by the Progressives.
Again, the next Premier of the Cayman Islands, Minister Roy McTaggart, ladies and gentlemen. And you know, I'm also glad he raised the issue of employment, and in particular this government's track record on employment, because I heard one of the opponent candidates on the radio this afternoon actually having the audacity to criticize the employment track record of this administration. And because I kind of sort of had a thing to do with some of the success, but also more importantly the relevance of our next speaker, which will hopefully be soon brought to light, also had a significant hand in it. But the truth, in fact, is, and don't take my word for it, look at the Labor Force Survey 2018-2019. They say it ain't bragging if he's telling the truth, so I'm going to tell the truth. Employment in this country is exactly as the minister stated. We halved it as an administration. Under this government, employment and unemployment has been the lowest it has ever been in decades of any administration. And I say that as a fact. Yes, 2020 put a bit of a curveball in our plans, but certainly, who are you going to trust? Your coffee shop generals who got the answers for everything? Or the government who actually got you closer to 100% full employment for our people than any other government? But I want to tell you how. Thank you. I want to tell you how we did it, because it has relevance to our next and final speaker. Because there were some very important milestones made towards the advancement of Caymanians in employment under this administration. First and foremost, we separated the labor functions from the border control functions of immigration, and that's already starting to pay huge dividends with the creation of work and customs and border control. Another important milestone that we have been trying, certainly I think the previous administration tried it, but we were successful in achieving it, and this administration is going to have a very important role to pay, and that play, and that will be the requirement that all job advertisements have to be registered with the government vis-a-vis our new department work. Now, you can apply and put it anywhere else, but you have to register those vacancies with the government and work. And also, for the first time under this administration, we introduced a new digital online platform called Jobs Cayman, which will be the first platform offering job advertising, job searching, and job matching, whilst also providing a central database for unemployed Caymanians in which to access those jobs. These things are no small feats, ladies and gentlemen. These things are happening for the first time. And also through the Jobs Cayman portal, we can, for the first time, enable or ensure that the employment law, which gives our Caymanians the first bite at the apple on unemployment, can actually happen by ensuring only those Caymanians get the first bite at applying for those jobs. And again, I am proud of these achievements and the how in which we went about doing it. And whilst, yes, I certainly did have a hand in the making one or two contributions to those important milestones, the person that we really owe a debt of gratitude, and certainly I think it is, it's suiting, it's fitting, as we salute and celebrate what has been a stellar career in politics, and certainly one that will end as him demitting the seat of leader of this country. The Minister for Employment, who I had the pleasure to serve for 4 years and learn from and gain this valuable experience in which my colleague Roy McTaggart talked about, which will enable me to press forward to the finish line, the goals that we set up for ourselves in 2017 that will bring 100% employment to all of our Caymanians. The minister responsible for moving those important milestones also happened to be our Premier of the Cayman Islands. Please welcome our final speaker of the evening, the candidate for Red Bay and the Premier of the Cayman Islands. Put your hands together for the Honourable Alden McLaughlin. Excited to introduce my boss that I forget everything else exists. Just one quick public service announcement again. License plate 194382, 194382. You're blocking someone. I believe they're in the back trying to get out. So If you are the owner of license plate 194382, please come move your car and come back to hear what the Premier has to say. The Premier, ladies and gentlemen.
I need my music again. My hands was... My steps were quick. Good evening, Cayman. A special good evening. Well, it's good night now. Good evening to those of you who have taken the time to come and join us here tonight for this final rally. And also to those who are joining us online or listening on the radio. However you're listening to us, thank you all for tuning in, for listening. Folks, this is last lap time. By this time tomorrow night, some gonna be shouting and some gonna be crying. I want to be with those who are shouting. When the Saints come marching in, I want to be in that number. I want to thank everyone, truly from the bottom of my heart, for the incredible support, encouragement, compliments I and the government have received over the course of the last little while, but frankly, over the course of this past year. Tonight will be the last time I address the country as your premier. And I want to thank you for your support over the course of my entire political career, which now spans almost 20 and a half years. Three in government and the last two as your premier. But in case anybody out there might be thinking, I'm thinking about going home. Oh, no, 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 no. I want to make it very clear. As I just said, when the Saints come marching in tomorrow night, I aim to be in that number. Red Bay, Red Bay, Red Bay, I got you, and I know you got my back. Sammy might have planted that peas and corn down a gully, but it bear that it gonna kill poor old Sammy. Sammy dead, Sammy dead, Sammy dead, oh.
Second down a gully, and it there really kill poor Sammy.
Sammy dead, Sammy dead, Sammy dead,
Sammy dead, Sammy dead, Sammy dead.
All right, enough of that now. Folks, you know that this group of people whom I have had the honor and privilege to lead, some of them for 8 years, others for 4 years, has the competence, has the capability, has the compassion and the passion necessary to lead this country through the next 4 years and all that we will have to deal with. I can say that with confidence. You can believe that with confidence, because we have the track record to prove it. Sometimes I am absolutely amazed myself when I think that despite the fact that we lost almost 1 year to the COVID pandemic, what this government has been able to do, that no government in my experience has been able to do. I am not going to go through all of that. We've had, over the course of the campaign, many opportunities to talk to you about the achievements of the government and the plans of the government. And all our plans are contained in this document, Stronger, Safer Future. No other grouping, no other candidate, individual candidate, has been able to set out for you the people of this country a comprehensive plan of how they propose to take the country forward, whether it's with respect to health care, health insurance, pensions, education, infrastructure, financial services. No other grouping has been able to do so. You need to seriously consider that if you are thinking about voting for an independent who is not a member of the Alliance. Because as Austin has said, as Roy has said, as Joey has said, as Barbara has said, as Frank has said, as David has said, we are the only group that have taken the time to sit down and work out in advance where we will take this country when we win the elections tomorrow night and we go to our first meeting on Thursday morning to start to talk about who is going to be minister for what and what those plans are going to be. I saw in the Compass, I think it was today, that there is an attempt by some of the independents, Mr. Chris Saunders and some of the others, to work out amongst themselves who is going to be premier if they win. Well, folks, if you want to see how well independents can put together a government, hark back to the last election. The progressives only won 7 seats, but the progressives took the government because the 7 of us had agreed what our plans were going to be, and we knew how we could work together, who each other is, and what each of us are capable of, and we were able to make the necessary arrangements and compromises with enough other independents to put a government together. But 7 is not the majority of 19. So with all of the numbers that they had, the 12 that they had as independents, they couldn't put a government together. We did. Fast forward, we got into the House. They put together an opposition. They chose Mr. Ezard Miller as the leader of the opposition. He lasted all of 2 years before they kicked him out. And they put Mr. Arden in. They still couldn't keep together. Kenneth, he plays musical chairs. He was in the opposition. He wanted to come in the government. He came over and sat with us for 1 day. Then he went back over to the opposition. He said he couldn't work with Ezard, so he left the opposition and went and sat by himself. When Arden became leader of the opposition 2 years later, he went and joined the opposition again. He lasted 3 weeks. He was back in the opposition again. The point I'm making, ladies and gentlemen, lots of people have ability, lots of people have great ideas. But unless you are prepared to put your ego one side, as we say, and work with a group of people in the best interests of the country, you cannot form a government, let alone keep a government together and achieve things for your people. We have the progressives has a proven track record. We know how to govern. We know what to do. We know how to keep you safe. We know how to keep the economy strong. We know how to lower unemployment and provide opportunities for our people. Why would you go looking at this stage to find some alternative to us when any number could play as far as they're concerned? The only sure way of ensuring that this country continues on the path of prosperity, on the path of safety, is to vote for those who are tried and true, proven and tested, the progressives-led alliance. Folks, I was so disappointed and saddened on Saturday night at something that my opponent in Red Bay did. Not disappointed for myself, not worried for myself, but I said, if this man truly means the country well, is putting himself up as an alternative to me, how can he go overseas, get a lawyer who made his millions in Grand Cayman, Ian Paget Brown, but who no longer lives here, who raises racehorses in Virginia, to put together a video to say how terrible financial services is doing in Cayman under our administration? Ladies and gentlemen, nothing could be further from the truth. And if you doubt what I say, ask yourselves, of all of the 800 plus lawyers in Cayman, the more than 1,000 accountants, I don't know how many mutual funds administrators and people who work in banking, of all of them who live here, Sammy couldn't find one of them to come say, oh, Alden and Tara and the government are destroying financial services. He had to go to Virginia to get somebody who no longer even lives here to condemn what we are doing with respect to financial services. You know the reason why he don't have anybody that was here, that is here, saying the things that Mr. Paget Brown said? Is because he couldn't get anybody here to do so. Because it's not true. It's not true. You know, we all want to win. Believe you me, this is my sixth race. And I think anyone who knows me knows I'm just a little competitive. Nobody wants to lose. But I will never seek to destroy one of the key industries of this island, which is keeping us afloat because we don't have any tourism right now, financial services, in my avarice to become an elected member. He is a lawyer. He should be ashamed of himself to want to destroy the financial services industry just to win a seat in Red Bay. Ladies and gentlemen, it is character. Seriously, it is character you must look at when you are choosing who to vote for. Not just the sweet words that proceedeth from their mouths. Look at their character. Look at their track record. Ask yourselves what Johan Moxham or Sammy Jackson has done for anybody in this community. He couldn't even find the sailing club in Red Bay. He had to hire Sherry-Ann as a guide to show him where that was. But he wanted to represent my constituency. Folks, they are not interested in representing the people. They are interested in the trappings of power to be able to control and to direct. But they don't understand in the first place that you do not just represent the country, you represent the constituency which elected you, and you are accountable first to them and their welfare. If they never learn that lesson, they will never get elected. That is for sure. Because as them old people say, unless I don't know anything about Cayman politics, come this time tomorrow night, both Sammy Jackson and Johan Moxham will be on Glass Bottle Reef. Folks, I need to say to you, I have every confidence that the Progressives Alliance is going to form the next government. I have every confidence. All my years of political experience, all of my moving around, all of my soundings tell me that is going to be the case. But we must not be complacent, as someone before me said. We need each and every one of you to not only do your part by voting for the Progressive candidate, Alliance candidate in your constituency, but we also need you to encourage your friends and family to do so as well. We want one massive celebration about this time tomorrow night when we can, as the old song say, when we can walk down Freedom Street once again. But I need to caution you. You see these pretty shirts we have on? We can't wear them to the polls tomorrow. Now, I can't tell you shouldn't wear red, because there's so many colors in this campaign. Some got blue, some got yellow, some got white, some got orange. So you got to wear some color. But you can't have no progressives on it, because otherwise they might not make you vote. So we don't want any problems at the polls with our people. So please dress appropriately, but please go. And as Roy said, vote, vote, vote. But only for progressives or alliance candidates if you live in one of those constituencies. I am also going to say tonight that if you live in East End, vote for Isaac Douglas Rankin. Arden has passed his best if used by date. He's a good little fella. Time for him to go into retirement now. Isaac is the man. And because I do not want Arden to be lonely, also, we need to send Mr. Ezard home as well, so him and Arden can keep company. Vote for Jay Ebanks in Northside. If you are in West Bay South, vote for Andre Ebanks. He's your man. And if you are in Savannah, vote for Heather Borden. She's your woman. And if you are in Newlands, vote for Alva Al Sako. And obviously, you have to vote for the Alliance candidates in Bordentown East, Dwayne John Seymour, and Bordentown West, Mr. Vincent Frederick. And in Prospect, the man himself who's here to defend himself, Mr. Austin Harris. And he bought him in them West Bears, and I'm going no further down there. But ladies and gentlemen, if you vote for those candidates and they win, it ain't no question about who the government is. It will be a progressive-led alliance once again. A government that has proven to you that we can navigate the roughest weather that there is, that we will still succeed and bring you in to calm waters. Now, I would be misleading you if I told you I believe the next couple of years are going to be easy. We have massive challenges facing the world. Management of this pandemic is still very much up in the air. Even though many countries are rolling out the vaccines, and by the way, Cayman now has 61% of its adult population vaccinated, at least one dose. 61%. No country in the world has reached that except our friends in Gibraltar, where they vaccinated every single soul who was over 16. But their population is about half what ours is. But it's not just that and the economic consequences that flow from it. But I was referring earlier to Sami's betrayal of our financial services industry. The difficulties that we face with keeping financial services viable are real. We are constantly under pressure from the EU and soon come from the United States. because no question about it, they view Cayman as a competitor. And all of the measures that they can conceive of to make things difficult for us, they conceive of them. But if Cayman wants to continue to stand tall in the global community and provide financial services to the world, which is what we do, we are an international financial services center. We sell services to the world. We have to be prepared to comply with the regulatory requirements of the EU, of the OECD, of the FATF with respect to anti-money laundering and countering terrorist financing. We can't say, as Johan has said, that we should just tell the EU to go take a jump. If we want to play in the global market, we have to adhere to global standards. Folks, this takes people who have the experience and understanding, not just of financial services, but of diplomacy. I'm not going to try to compete with him. It needs people who know how to deal in the international arena. I have made many trips to Brussels, the United States, Washington, London, Berlin, Paris, dealing with these issues in the international arena. That is what Cayman continues to need. Not one of them out there who are complaining and questioning our ability to deal with these issues and our track record in dealing with these issues even begin to understand what that involves. In this administration, you will have not only myself, but the new premier-to-be, Roy McTaggart, who has a long career in financial services. No other grouping out there has that level of experience and competence. Folks, we cannot risk handing these issues over to a group of inexperienced and rash individuals, no matter how well-intentioned they may be. There is a place for newer people to come into government, otherwise we'd have to stay there until we die and you still have to replace us. I am not suggesting that we should not elect newer, younger people. I'm saying you should not do so in a way that puts them in charge because they just won't know how to deal with the issues. A lot of people believe that because they've been successful in some business or as a lawyer or as an accountant or whatever, that automatically qualifies them to be a good representative. Let me tell you something, folks. After 20 plus years, when I came in as a young lawyer as well, I thought I knew everything. You really don't know much about politics, a whole different vocation. You have to learn it the same way you have to learn any other trade or any other profession. You got to learn it by experience, and experience you only get by experience. It takes time to get there. So folks, don't risk Cayman's future on a group of completely inexperienced individuals who claim they will be led by Chris Saunders. Folks, we cannot do that to this country. We will all rue the day and damn the hour that occurs. Ladies and gentlemen, it is late. It is 11 o'clock. This is 1 hour before election day arrives. I want to thank you all again for your support through the campaign. I thank you in advance for your support at the polls tomorrow. We love you. We care for you. We want to be your representatives one more time. So folks, vote the Progressives Alliance all the way. Tell all your friends and family to do the same. And let us start celebrating tomorrow night the return of the current administration, who are able to lead this country for the next 4 years and hopefully navigate us into calmer, better waters than we are currently experiencing. Good night. I love you. Thank you for the opportunity to have been your premier. I love you.
Hello, this is Alden McLaughlin. To all my constituents in Red Bay, I want to say that it has been an honor and privilege to serve as your representative these past 4 years. I remain committed to you and our wonderful community of Red Bay, and to continuing to work to ensure that Red Bay remains a safe and tranquil place for us to live and raise our families. Much has been done this term to relieve the traffic problems in Red Bay, and when the current work underway is completed in the coming months, we will see major improvements in travel times and congestion generally. I will also continue the work begun this term to upgrade the roads in our constituency, improve drainage, and create parks and green spaces. I therefore humbly ask for your vote on April the 14th to secure a stronger, safer future for all Caymanians and residents. Vote for me, Alden McLaughlin, number 2 in Red Bay.
This is a paid promotion by the Progressives.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, just before you run off, we do have just one quick public service announcement. Persons have asked specifically where they will be voting, what the polling stations will be for the persons who are, of course, standing behind me. So I will just say this for those of you who don't know. For Georgetown Central, you can vote at the Georgetown Town Hall, now called Constitution Hall. Georgetown East, you will be voting at the First Baptist Church Hall. Georgetown West, voting will take place at Cayman Prep. Georgetown South, voting will take place at John Gray High School. Georgetown North, voting will take place at Georgetown Primary. Red Bay, voting will take place at Red Bay Primary. And if you're voting in Prospect for Austin Harris, number 1 in Dunn, you're voting at the Prospect Primary School. Ladies and gentlemen, we thank you all very much for being out here tonight. Okay, I just got a clarification from the member in Georgetown West. This is Cayman Prep School on Smith Road, not the Cayman Prep School that's on Walker's Road. Two quick things. We do have a key missing here for a Honda vehicle. If you're missing a key for a Honda vehicle and you can describe the keychain, really? This is yours. What is it? What's the outstanding thing on the keychain? That silver, the little copper thing, the penny. A penny a day, yes. Here you go, this is yours. Here you go. Last but not least, my friends, I just want to state to you this very clear message. It is absolutely important, and I cannot understate it enough, maintaining stability in this country. Tomorrow is the day, and the alliance is the only way. Strong, stable leadership with a proven track record to move this country forward. We thank you all for coming out. Have a safe and enjoyable evening and get home safely. Thank you very much.
Came on stronger now. Came on stronger now. Came on stronger now. We coming stronger now. We coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Put your hands for the progress. Serving you. Coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Stronger safer came on.
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 Progressive all the way. Put your ex for the progressive. Serving you. Came on.
coming stronger now. We coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Came on stronger now. Came on stronger now. We coming stronger now. We coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Put your hands for the progress. Serving you is the objective. We going all the way. Progress is all the way. Came on stronger now. Came on stronger now. We coming stronger now. We coming stronger now. This country stronger now. This country stronger now. Let's keep it stronger now. Let's keep it stronger. Stronger say my game on.
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 Stronger say my game
on. Came on strong.